This video is designed to step you through the PWS metric for reporting for community water systems. If you have any issues getting logged in or have questions regarding the metrics, you will need to contact either Sean Stevenson or Brian Tarver at our drop portal email address or phone number. Let me get started here. And this is the landing page for the customer support center. And I'm going to log in. And this is our list of water systems I'm associated to. You may have landed on this page that has your contact information. If you got this page, you're going to go to account, and it's going to bring up all of the water systems associated to you. Most of you only have a few. This is my test system, so I'm associated with a number of water systems. And I'm going to scroll down here until I see one that I'm pretty sure is a community system. So let me try one of our test systems there and see what we have. And this is our landing page for where we've launched the application. It gives a little instructions on how to, you know, move back and forth in the application. But I'm going to show you, you know, there's a back button if you miss something and need to go back and make a correction. Each page has a next and save progress button at the top right. And at the very end, you want to make sure you have the submit final form. I'm going to click next. And it's going to have your contact information. We want to make sure we have a valid mailing and phone number. Click next. And this is where we verify that the PWS was operating and that you were in charge of it in 2020. Almost everybody's going to click yes. The only reason you may hit no is if the PWS wasn't open in 2020 and or you weren't in charge of it in 2020, so you have no idea what the metrics would have been. So I'm going to select yes and click next. And this is where I verify that I have read and understand the metric tools, so I have to check this box. And I'm going to select next. And the first of our metrics questions is water system expenses. So we want to know the expenses in 2020. So and was this actual or estimate? Each of your answers will have the choice of if that's an actual result or an estimate. I can type any needed comments down here. We're not required to put comments in here, but if there's something that you feel you need to explain, you can enter that in the comments. So I'm going to click next. And it is the water system revenue. This is used for calculating the operating ratio. So my revenue was 155. And maybe that's just an estimate. And as soon as I enter that, the operating ratio gets calculated and displayed up here. And I'm going to hit next. And what's this one? Total number of service connections. Service connections for my water system. So That's the actual thing of what that is. If you ever have any questions, this show hide example can help you explain a little bit more what the question is asking. So if you click that, it's going to give a little more of a description of what we are looking for in the question. So it'll show this, and I can unclick it, and it will hide it again. And then we hit next. And the number of distribution water lines varies. Let's see, 35 I think last year. And again, there's a show hide examples. So it just gives an example of what you need to look at for answering the question. And then I hit next. For the length of distribution pipe. And then 25 miles. I can also do this in feet. And that's an that's an estimate. Okay, next. Total amount of billed exported water. And the total amount of billed exported water in either gallons or millions of gallons. This would include water exported through interconnections, such as a permanent pipe connected to another water system. The other water systems that receive the water is billed for their usage, for example, through an annual contract. Usage must be accounted for. If this usage is not metered, it must be estimated. And again, there's a little more information on what this question's asking for. So I'm going to put it in 10 million gallons, and it's actual. Next, and total amount of billed metered consumption. The amount of billed metered consumption for 2020 in either gallons or millions of gallons includes water billed to metered service connections and water sold through metered bulk station. Once again, there's a show hide example, and it will give a couple of examples of what you might have had. With build meter, I have 10, it'll be 20. Do that, and use gallons instead of millions of gallons, and say that's an estimate. And then I'm going to click next. Unmetered consumption. This is a three-part, maybe four-part question. Did you have any billed unmetered consumption? If you say no, you're going to click next and it'll enter zero. If I do have billed unmetered consumption, I'm going to click yes. And then it's going to ask me, do I have meter data that can determine how much of the volume of that? If I say yes, I'm going to click next and enter what that meter data is. If I don't have meter data for that, I'm going to click no. And it's going to ask me whether, and we have to estimate this through either population or service connection. And there's a calculation that goes behind both of these, whether it's population or service connections. But the question is, do I know the population? If I know the population, I'll hit yes. If I don't know the population, but do know the number of service connections, I'll hit no. And go next, and it's going to ask me how many service connections are related to the billed unmetered consumption. I'm going to hit next. And enter your unmetered number of service connections. So maybe I only had 15 that were unmetered, and change that to actual. And the calculation for service connections and volume of water gets me from that 15 to 1.335 million gallons. So I'm going to hit next. And total amount of water produced. Million gallons. And is this result estimate? And again, this show height example will give you a little bit more help. And do that. I'll click next. Total number of planned repair, rehabilitation, and replacement tests. Well, I had 75 planned repairs. And I'm going to hit next. Total number of unplanned repair, rehabilitation, and replacement tests. And 22. Think estimate. And I'm going to hit next. And this is our last customer service metric, and it's one that you get to pick. So we have a drop-down list of some standard customer service metrics, and say I pick total number of water complaints, I'm going to hit next, and it'll ask me for that metric, the answer to that. I can also pick other, and if I do that, it's going to give me a block to describe what that other customer service metric that I tracked is. So I'm going to go back and pick the number of water complaints and send next. And it's going to ask me to go in there. I only had 4 complaints last year. And I'm certain with it. I'm going to hit next. And this is just kind of a review of everything I just entered and some calculations for some of the metrics that we need. So I can review this basically and see if everything looks right. If something looks completely wrong, I can use the back button and go back and correct anything that I miss. So if I go back, let's say wasn't the number of complaints, I'm going back. I actually only had 15 replacement tests. So if I go back and I change something, I do want to hit next because I have to hit next to save it. I'm going to hit next. And from here, I can step through it, or I can navigate through using these. But I'm just going to step through just to make sure everything looks correct. And hit next. And this is my certification that says I have reviewed the contingency planning and asset management rules. I'm implementing my asset management rules. And that the metrics data that I just entered is true and accurate to the best of my knowledge. I'm going to certify that I'm authorized to submit this, consent to sign electronically. I'm going to come down here and try to get my name in here. And sign it. And then print my name at the bottom. And put my title. And come back up here and hit next. And this lets me review what I just submitted. So I'm going to open up this PDF document. And note that it says this is created prior to submission. You have not submitted at this point. This is just letting you review what you have done. I'm going to scroll down through here, and it's going to show me exactly what I entered. It's going to show me calculations for the revenue water, which was billed plus metered plus unmetered. and all my calculations. So I'm gonna scroll down here. And it's, this is specifically every answer you put in. And you can review it, and it goes down to this unmetered consumption one with the kind of the odd one where I had to answer, yes, I did have it, but no, I didn't have it metered. And yes, I have the number of service connections. So it calculated this much for 15 service connections. And again, I'm just reviewing everything that I submitted, my customer service metric. I selected total number of water complaints, and it gives me my answer, and it was the actual answer and a signature page. So if everything on this looks correct, I checked that I have reviewed it. Again, if there was a problem, I can use the back button and go back to the section that needs fixed. And I'm going to hit next. And this says you're ready to submit. Once you submit, then we lock your application so you won't be able to revise it again. If you have an issue with it, you'll need to contact Sean Stevenson or myself. But I'm going to submit the final form, and you have to make sure you do submit the final form. Last year, we had some people stop right before we got this far. I'm going to submit. And it's going to give me a submission ID number when I submitted. Contact information if we have any questions. And here is the final copy of the application that I can open. I can print it. I can save it. You may want to make sure you either print it or save it so that you have a record of what you submitted. And it's essentially that same form we just reviewed. And that is all it takes to submit your community metrics. Thank you.